press the bell icon and never miss an update from Digital Hash.
My journey to Mirzapur was basically just a phone call from Karan, Anshuman, one of the creators. And he thought that I would probably suit to be a part of the world of Mirzapur as one of the directors, because at that point Karan and Gurmmeet were already directing. And the material is so much, it's 400 minutes of content, around 400-450 pages of script. So there was a lot we had to, the three of us had to sort of put our minds to and culminate and make a show that is this grand. The brief that I got from Karan, Gurmmeet, Puneet also is that they want to make a show that has obviously been never seen in the country before or in India before. The story, I would say, is your usual gangster graph, right? But what makes it fun is the characters. And what was new for me to sort of direct was the fact that the violence is in camera. It's unlike anything we've seen before. And that was a lot of fun to sort of do. And of course, keep it very engaging with great cliffhangers. And of course, we shouldn't forget, it's always about the characters. There was no apprehension while making, because we wanted to make what was written on script. We wanted to stay true to the script. If it says there are swear words, sure, we got to shoot the swear words. If it says someone's head is being blown off or fingers are being chopped off, we have to shoot it. We'll discuss that and figure that out in the edit. When three minds are attached to a singular project, especially something that's more of a television or a series, you know, which is a web series or a TV show, we have to remember it's not really a director's medium. It's more of a writer, producer and creator's medium. So they clearly come with a sense that they've written, that they know that this world is about ABC or whatever. And we have to execute that to the best of our ability. So there was no tussle, but of course there were disagreements. And if there are no disagreements, the project is not creative enough. You know, so during the edit, there were a lot of disagreements. Should we add this scene? Should we remove this scene? And that's the fun of it. Yeah, sure. We had our debates along with the editor. Let's not forget, editor is a huge part of the writing process in the post. And we had a lot of discussions. We've done changes that you have no idea, which is very, very, very different from the script actually. A lot of changes have been made, episodes have been swapped. These are secrets to how Mirzapur has shaped up, you know. So there were disagreements, but only for the good. We did obviously sit a lot and try and decide the tonality, and I did have some issues in the beginning because, again, like I said, I wasn't part of the pre-production process. But eventually you start getting a hang of it, you know, because in the end our focus as directors have to be how true you are to the actors, how much the actors trust you and how you're getting the kind of performances out, because eventually the writers, creators and of course Gurmmeet, because he's done most of the episode, they have set a tone, you know, they've set a world. And we just have to reach there, work constantly with the actors and make sure we extract the best out of them. It's very simple, right? This is a show that Karan, Puneet have been writing for probably 2 years and they know what they're doing. When we see Sacred Games, we know Netflix has a certain kind of an audience that they are reaching out to. Sacred Games is a book, which is a lot more, it's a lot deeper. It's a lot, I don't know what the word is, but it's a lot more layered, you know. So that has its own audience. Mirzapur is all about the characters and how they sort of take us on their journey in a land that we're not familiar with. So honestly, there was nothing in our minds. And we must remember that when we are talking about web streaming, when we are talking about the internet, we've got to remember that this platform that we have is all about coexistence. You know, a Netflix must coexist. Z, Alt, YouTube, of course Amazon, we all need to coexist, because in the end we are sort of a part of the same world. So all kinds of content is great content. I have no idea. Being in this country, I've seen a lot of changes. Anyway, I've seen the old Chashme Badur, which starts with a close-up of a cigarette being smoked, as opposed to Chashme Badur now, where there'll be a sign saying "Do not smoke" or "Cigarette smoking is injurious to it." So change can happen anytime. You'd never know it. My hope is in web, the stronger platforms which are more international, like Netflix, Amazon, put their foot down and say they're not going to let this happen. To be honest with you, as a creator, as a filmmaker, I would like to believe even without the swear words, Mirzapur was a strong enough story and it had strong characters to survive. So it's not like the swear words are making Mirzapur better. But of course, the fun of it, the flavor of it would be lost if the swear words were beeped out. The fact that there is a streaming awards by Digital Hash itself is so empowering for filmmakers like us, because we have, me personally, I have started my career doing non-fiction work, which is television, and a lot of work which is online. So you'll find my short films online, you'll find it on Vimeo, you'll find random videos that I used to make, just put it up in the hope that I get gigs out of it, and I did. Which basically means the internet is so strong, streaming is so strong, that it needs to get its due. And thankfully, the Digital Hash and other platforms are sort of giving awards to content that's online, because this is the content we enjoy watching, to be honest. This is the content we want to make, and we hope that like-minded people do check out. So it's great to have the streaming awards, and thank you so much. For all the latest updates on web entertainment, log on to thedigitalhash.com.